The Lives of the Saints by the Reverend Alban Butler, taken from the 4th edition, published in 1954. July 30th, St. Abdon and St. Sennen, Martyrs. They were Persians, but, coming to Rome, courageously confessed the faith of Christ in the persecution of Decius in 250. They were cruelly tormented, but the more their bodies were mangled and covered with ghastly wounds, the more were their souls adorned and beautified with divine grace and rendered glorious in the sight of heaven. The Christians at Rome did not treat them as strangers, but as brethren, united to them in the hope of the same blessed country, and after their death carefully deposited their bodies in the house of a subdeacon called Quirinus. In the reign of Constantine the Great, their relics were removed in the ancient burying place of Pontian, so called from some rich man who built it, called also from some sign ad ursum palatium. It afterwards received its name from Saints Abdon and Sennen. It was situated near the Tiber, on the road to Porto, near the gates of Rome. The images of these martyrs, with Persian bonnets and crowns on their heads, and their names are to be seen there at this day in ancient sculpture. Saints Abdon and Sennen are mentioned in the ancient Liberian calendar and in other martyrologies, though their modern acts deserve no notice, as Cardinal Norris has demonstrated. The martyrs preferred torments and death to sin, because the love of God above all things reigned in their breasts. "We say we are Christians," says Tertullian. "We proclaim it to the whole world, even under the hands of the executioner, and in the midst of all the torments you inflict upon us to compel us to unsay it. Torn and mangled and weltering in our blood, we cry out as loud as we are able to cry, that we are worshippers of God through Christ." Upon which Mr. Reeves observes that no other religion ever produced any considerable number of martyrs except the true one. Do we ever read of any generation of men so greedy of martyrdom, who thought it long till they were upon the rack, and were so patient, so cheerful, and steadfast under the most intolerable torments? Only the Christians suffered at this rate, and they held on suffering for several hundred years together, till they had subdued the world by dying for their religion. What could engage such a number of men in such a religion, and support them in it, in defiance of death in the most shocking forms, but evident truth, and a superior grace and strength from above?